What is up, Pokemon fans? Professor Prometheus Pine here, and welcome back to another episode of Pining for Pro. In this episode, we actually are running a Yveltal team built by James Baek. His YouTube channel will be linked down in the description below. Alright, so the basic idea of this team is going to be to activate the weakness policy on Yveltal. We have a couple of different ways we can do that, either with Regieleki or with the Mamos. Basically, what this is going to do is everything is built around the Yveltal here. So, we're going to be boosting up the defenses with Regieleki as well as dealing a lot of damage and then activating weakness policy with Pokemon like Mamoswine. With Yveltal, this Pokemon could then set up the Airstreams, giving speed boosts to your Tapu Fini, Metagross, and to a lesser extent, Incineroar. It also gives boosts to Mamoswine. The Tapu Fini, Mamoswine, and Metagross really enjoy these boosts and can deal a lot of damage if they are able to outspeed your opponent's Pokemon. Finally, once Dynamax is over, if your Yveltal is still alive, it's going to be attacking first, I mean, outside of priority with the plus speeds from the Max Airstreams. It has access to the flying type move Oblivion. This will allow you to deal damage with that attack and then heal up some hit points from draining them of their health. This is great because hopefully you will be super fast because of the speed boost, as well as your special attack will be pretty high thanks to the weakness policy. So basically today, just want to test out this team. I've had a few different battles testing out how this runs, but as you can see, we're basically back to where we were from last week. So we'll give it a try. I did try out the Kyogre team a little more, and I was able to do a bit better off-screen, but, you know, thumbs the brakes. We'll see if we can get a few wins with the Yveltal this week. And if you guys haven't heard of James Baek, he's a great player, and has some great videos on his channel. You guys should go check that out. Alright, we are facing what appears to be a pseudo-rain team with a Zacian. This could be interesting. I am a little worried about that Thundurus, but honestly, I don't really see a reason not to lead Yveltal. Zacian is kind of a problem, I will not lie. I think I will try Yveltal and probably Mamoswine. I feel like that's a decent combination to get the ball rolling. Well, Mamoswine and Regieleki here. I'm gonna go with Mamoswine. Put Regieleki in the back as a countermeasure, and then either Metagross or Incineroar. The last. Come on. Our Incineroar doesn't have Darkest Lariat, so I'm gonna go with the Metagross right now. Let's see what we face. Alright, so, looking at the start of the battle, what do we got here so far? Loving the outfit. Can you give me that to myself? Okay, you're facing the Dragapult and the Thundurus. Thundurus is another good reason not to run the Incineroar, because it will activate abilities. I think we're going to max. Yeah, I think We're gonna max dark into the Dragapult. And probably Icicle Crash. Thundurus. What this will do is allow us to hit the Dragapult pretty hard. I was debating there about my Sherman into the Yveltal, but we do have the Focus Sash on the Mammoth Swine. This will allow us to get good damage across the board. And of course, we do have the Prankster. What am I thinking? Prankster. I'm confused. Pokemon names are hard today. On the Thundurus, that's going to allow us to dodge that Eerie Impulse. That's great, because that could have been a pretty crippling effect otherwise. And now what we can do is we can hit the Thundurus with, I guess, Darkness. From here, I'm probably gonna Ice Shard into the Dragapult. I think that's a better play. That'll get rid of the Dragapult. Yeah, what's nice is we did get burned. Now, that doesn't sound great, because obviously we're dealing this damage, but we're dealing this damage, so that's great. Our Ice Shard isn't gonna deal as much damage to our Yveltal on the sides here. Would have been nicer probably to max Airstream to get the speed boost, but get that next turn. Honestly, it's not going to matter because Thundurus is out, we can outspeed that. They haven't Dynamaxed anything yet, which is kind of worrying in a format where Dynamax is a key feature. It is definitely important to dish out your damage while you can. But it's also great to be able to Dynamax after your opponent. That really gives you an advantage. But with this team, that's not really the case we want. And honestly, I think I'm gonna be able to Earthquake, actually. The Zacian does kind of. They might be able to two-shot me with the Kingdra, and as well as the Zacian. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna Earthquake that A gets spread damage, and B hits the Zacian for super effective damage. And I did kind of a dumb move. I max flared. That is going to be lower damage on my belt. Okay, but they do target the Mammoth Swine. I think that is a poor decision on their end. I don't think Zacian's going to be able to survive. Or is going to be able to knock out my belt in one shot. Exactly, alright. So that's great, because now that we do have Max Flare set up, we are able to set the weather to sun. Now, unfortunately, we're not going to be able to take really advantage of the sun, as our opponents are probably going to set it again, but what we can do is hopefully could probably not really much else we can do. We are going to lose both, but... well, in that case, they did go for the... We would never know which Pokemon would be the target. It could have been either or. It didn't really matter for them. They outsped either way. And that does set up rain again. We'll have to, this will be a close one for sure. This is what I'm talking about, being able to climax after. It does give you a little bit of a advantage. From here, honestly, I can bolt switch. And stomping tantrum. A great play on their end would be to double protect the Zacian. But given the aggressive style they have, I don't anticipate that's going to be an issue. Now the Max Geyser is probably going to be the Metagross. That could make a difference. And we survive. Okay. It's close. I don't think we can one-shot the King. Yeah, we can drop. Kingdra does always have access to the muddy water as well, but we'll try for the Volt Switch, and probably the Stomping Tantrum. Or if they do target single targets, okay, it does have both. Alright, well, breaking my opponent. As we can see, that does highlight the damage later. It might be smart with this team to hold off on the Yveltal in the beginning. But, alright. Moving to learn. Let's see what we have for a second battle. Or what my opponent has. Okay, standard. Come on, Hurricane, protect. Case this is like Rock Slide. Pretty common Zacian as well. Adamant. Okay. Alright. So we will see what the next battle takes us. I have to say, this is definitely the worst I have done laddering in a long time. I do have to get used to the trying out teams from other players. Okay, we do have a Groudon Sun Team, slash Sand Team. Okay. I must say, I have not faced anything quite like this. Incin. We do want to bring the Tapu Fini, we want access to the terrain. But Regieleki or Metagross. Fortunately, all three of my remaining Pokemon are to ground, but I think of Regieleki. Intimidate is nice from Incineroar, but I don't think it's gonna be use that much, unfortunately. as I was saying, starting to say before, this team, like all of the teams in my series, will be listed under my website, PrometheusPine.com, if you want to check out those rental teams, as well as more. They will be coming very soon. We do have a lead of... Some of them are pretty good, but it's just not my cup of tea. So with this, in their case, I would probably use the Dracozolt. Yes. This is a good call on my opponent's end, being able to use both. Oblivion Wing, Venusaur, and Earthquake. I think it's going to be the better play. I had a feeling that's what I was going to see. Probably going to lose the Yveltal, but that was really, I think, what I had to do in order to keep the, And what is nice with both for super effective and unfortunate type of is going to be policy. Yeah. But that isn't really going to matter because what we can do now is set up a Regieleki. Is Volt Switch, actually. That sounds like a decent plan to the Tyranitar, because we can Ice Shard into the Dracozolt. Tyranitar does protect, which is probably fine. No, we're not getting the double switch. It's actually probably better. Interested to see what my opponent is going to do for their Dynamax option. Probably going to be Venusaur. So it might be smart to probably lower speed. I could see a switching into Groudon, and then from there we have to watch out for the Venusaur. Another speed boost. I imagine they are going to Dynamax. You always have to watch out with Venusaur because they do have the start getting comfortable with them not using Sleep Hut. Tends to be when they use it. So protect from Mamoswine. I think that's going to be good. Probably gonna get outsped either way, but in the event that they don't, they aren't able to knock out Mammoth Swine, we do reset the weather, as well as dish out quite a bit of damage. But we'll have to see how this goes. Thankfully, if we do manage to knock out these Pokemon, then next turn, the Violash was over. Good call on my opponent's end. I should probably Dynamax Mammoth Swine a turn earlier. That's a great call on my opponent's end. Make the light screen. Okay, so we should have went into. That was probably the smarter call anyway. Looking back, going into Groudon. Going into Groudon would guarantee the hit. As well as if we did manage to hit them, either knock it out, be one or two hit KO. And after that, we could deal with Venusaur another time. And there's really nothing we can do from here. So that was a good move from our opponent's end. The combination of a Gigantamax Venusaur and a Sun setup, usually either Torkoal or Groudon, so it's a really good combo. I especially like the Groudon combination. I found that even when I built my teams and I was doing well with them, top 2,000, I think, at my peak. It was a pain to battle them. I think I lost to them the most of any sort of team. All right, let's see what we can do. So the team we are going to face next. It blows my mind, the amount of time it'll take sometimes, whereas other times it's just, you'll match up almost instantly. On the bright side, the team I have planned for next video is one that I have extensive work with, so hopefully we can net some wins and get to Ultra Balls here at least. But there we go. I do enjoy this Yveltal team. Alright, it looks like we're facing a Zacian Lapras team. Spoilers to the upcoming weeks of the channel. But this is nice because it does provide the coverage from our Incineroar's Intimidate. The Lapras I do worry about. I'm thinking Regieleki Metagross in the beginning, and then from there having the Mammoth Swine Yveltal in the back will. But we're definitely going to see the Lapras hitting first. As for what it's paired with, I wouldn't be surprised, honestly, if Moongus was out first. Maybe even a Moongus eject button. Eject button, rage powder. See what our opponent does end up bringing up. Thunder, a Sushi Rocket. Maybe a Tail End. Honestly, I could probably bullet punch into the Lapras to guarantee the KO. That might be the call, actually. Especially if they do. Sleep. it's probably the best play. This is the best turn that could have happened, actually. And we play face optimization. Survives. Mamoswine wakes up. Nice. And it hits the icicle crash. That is a great turn for us. From here, I don't imagine. I see no reason to not earthquake max lightning. Awesome. Regieleki comes in clutch. The Dynamax Regieleki does win us our one match for the day. Alright guys, I think that's gonna be it for today. If you you wanna catch more videos in the Pining for Pro series, watch me hopefully one day get to Master Ball rank this month. Keep on following the channel, like the video, subscribe so that you can stay up to date on all of my new content. I will catch you guys all next time. Professor Prometheus Pine, out.